Hi guys, welcome to Simplified Coding again, and now let's move ahead in our project. In the previous video, we have done with the thumbnail preview and the input validations. But all these stuffs that we did are the client-side things. The final task is to save the category given to Firebase. And for the category, we have a thumbnail image, we have a name, and we have a description. The name and the description can be easily stored in Firebase database as they are simple strings, or you can say text. But we cannot store the thumbnail in the Firebase database as this is a file. Now here we will involve the Firebase storage as well. We will upload the thumbnail image to Firebase storage and we will store the thumbnail URL in Firebase database. Okay. And this is what we are going to do in this video. So if you remember the video where we discussed our database structure, then for categories, we have a node categories. Inside categories, we will have the category name. Inside the category name, we will have thumbnail and description for every category. For thumbnail, we will store the URL of the thumbnail and the file is actually stored in Firebase storage. Okay. And the description is just a normal string. So this is how our category will look in Firebase database. Okay. So the first thing we need to do is we need to create the Firebase reference. Okay. So first what we will do, we will create a node for this categories and inside that node, we will create the node of the name given for the category. Okay. Now we also need to check if this category, whatever is entered, is already exist on the database or not, because we want to create unique category names. Okay. So this is our task. Remember that. So the first thing we will do is just after finishing the validations, we will create a database reference object. Okay. And it is very simple. We just need to create a var. And you can name it anything. I am going to name it database. Okay. And then we will use firebase.database.ref. And inside the ref, we will pass the reference of which we want to create the reference. Okay. So here in this case, we want to create the reference of categories and then the entered category name. So what we will do here, we will pass categories, okay, and then a slash, and then we will concatenate the entered category name, okay. So this is the category name, cat name. So we will concatenate this thing, okay. So just concatenate it, cat name, that's it. So we have the reference of the entered category name inside Firebase. Now we will check if there is already some data in this reference, that means this category is already inserted in Firebase. Now in this case, we will not upload image, we will not add category, we will display an error message that the category is already exist in Firebase. Okay, so for this, we will read the value and this time we just need to read the value once. Okay. So for reading the value from this reference, we will use database dot once. Now this will read the value only once. Okay. And here we need to pass value. Okay. Then we will attach then. Okay. And then takes a function that returns us a snapshot. Okay. Now in this snapshot, we have the data. Okay. So what we will do, we will check if there is some data in this snapshot, that means the category is already added. If not, we can add the category. Okay. So it is very simple. So to check whether some data exists or not in this snapshot, we can simply use exist function. Okay. So here we will write if snapshot dot exist. Now, if snapshot exists, that means the category is already added, and in this case we will not add the category. Instead we will display an error message. Okay, and if you remember from the previous video, we have created a div here, div result, to display the error message. Okay, so we will use this div to display our error message. So let's do it. So here we will select the result, our result div that we created to display the error message, and we will add the attribute to div. Now we will add a class on the div, and the class name is alert-danger. Now this is again a bootstrap class to display error messages. Okay, and then we will display the message. So again we will select result.html and we will change the text to category already exist, and you can put just any message that you want. Okay, that's it, we have the error. Now in the else part, now if we come in the else, that means the category is not already added and we can store the category that is entered by the user. Okay, so in this case we will add the category. So let's do it. So we need to add the category. So for adding the category, first we need to upload the thumbnail image in Firebase storage. Okay, so the first task here is upload the selected thumbnail to Firebase storage. Okay, so this is our first task. So we will do this thing first. Now to upload the selected file in Firebase storage, first you need to go to your Firebase console and you need to open your project. So this is the Firebase project that we created, which is My Wallpaper App. Remember, you open the same project in your Firebase console. Okay, now from here we need to go to storage. Okay, now from this storage, copy this thing. Okay, I have some file, I will delete everything. Let's delete it. Okay, your storage may be empty. Okay, so that doesn't matter actually. What you need to do is you need to copy this thing from here. Copy, remember, copy only this thing. You do not need to copy gs:// copy this part only. Copy this, copy, come to your project, go to app.js, which is inside the JS folder. Okay, come to app.js, and here where you have your Firebase config object, inside storage bucket, which is right now empty, paste the text that you copied. Okay, so you have to paste this thing here. So this was the first step. Now we will upload the selected file. Okay, so come back in categories.html, and here we will write the code to upload the file. Okay, so let's do it. So first we will get the file name that was selected. Okay, so we will get var name equals to thumbnail name. Okay, now a big problem with Firebase storage is we cannot prevent overwriting of files. Okay, if you upload the file with the same name twice, then the previous file will be overwritten. So to prevent this, we have to generate unique names for every file that is going to be uploaded. Okay, so we have to generate unique names, and for unique name I will use timestamp. Okay, current time in milliseconds. So I will do this thing. So the first thing we need is we need the extension of the file that is selected. Okay, so we will extract the extension from this name. So let's do it. So we will create a new var ext, that means extension, and we will get the substring of this name. So we will write name dot substring. Okay, inside substring, the first parameter we will pass is name dot last index of. So we will get the index of the last dot that is in our name. And that is obvious that after the last dot, we have the extension. So we have the index of the last dot and we will go till the length. So here we will write for the second parameter name dot length. Okay, so we have the extension on this variable. That's it. Now what we will do is we will create the name, the unique name. Okay, so let's create another variable and let's name it thumb name. Okay, and we will use the date object get time. Now this get time returns the current time in milliseconds and it will create a unique name every time. Okay, so we have the unique name for our file. Okay, now we need to create a storage reference. So in our Firebase storage, we will create a folder with the name of the category where we are uploading the image. Okay, let's say we are uploading this image for the category. Let's say we have a category named nature and this thumbnail is for the category nature. Then in Firebase storage, we will create a folder named nature. Okay, and inside that folder, we will upload the thumbnail. Okay, very simple. So first we will create a storage reference. Let's do it. We have where storage reference equals to Firebase dot storage dot ref. And here we will pass the reference. As I told you, we will create a folder. So first we will pass the folder name and the folder name is the category name. And we already have the cat name variable having our category name. So we have cat name, then we will concatenate a forward slash and inside the cat name, we will upload the file with our unique name. And this is our unique name that we already generated. So we will concatenate this unique name, which is thumb name. Okay. And after that, we will concatenate the extension, which we already have in this ext variable. So plus ext. Okay. So we have the storage reference. Now we will simply put the file in the storage reference and we can use it using put method. So let's do it. So we will simply write storage ref dot put. Okay, so we will write storage ref dot put and we will write the thumbnail here, which is our selected file. Okay, we get the file here. You see, we have the thumbnail here that we got from the input type file. So we are uploading the file here. Now this method returns a task and we can store it in another variable. So here we can write where upload task equals to storage ref dot put and our file. Okay, now we need to track the upload progress. Okay, so for this we can write here upload task. We will use this variable upload task dot on and we will attach an state changed here. So we have state changed and the second parameter is a function that will actually we have three functions for the next parameters. Okay, so in state changed we have three functions. So let me write it like this so that you will get proper understandings. So the first function returns us the progress and this is function progress. It gives a snapshot that contains the progress. Okay, so this is our second parameter. This was the first parameter. We are attaching an state change. Then we have a function for getting the progress update. And then we have another function. And this function handles the errors. Okay, so we have a function named error and it returns us an error. Right now we are not handling the error. You can handle it if you want here. Okay, and the last function is the function that will be called after the completion. So this is the function complete. So we have three functions. One is for progress, one is for error, and one is for completion. Inside the progress, we will update our progress bar that we created here. Okay, so we have a progress bar to display the progress of upload, and we will use this progress bar to display the upload progress. Okay, so first we need to calculate the percentage that is uploaded. So here we will create a variable. Let's name it percentage equals to, and from this snapshot object we can calculate the percentage. Okay, so here we will write snapshot dot bytes transferred, which is the total bytes transferred, and we will divide it with snapshot dot total bytes. Okay, and to get the percentage we will multiply it with 100. Okay, very simple mathematics. So we have the percentage. Okay, now we will display this percentage inside our progress bar. Okay, so we have the ID for the progress bar. Let's check it. On the top. So we have this progress bar and the ID is upload progress. Okay, so we will display the progress here. So select this element here. We have the upload progress selected, and we will write the HTML here as percentage, and we can concatenate the percentage sign. Okay, and then we need to set the width of the progress bar as well to display the progress bar. So again, we will select upload progress, and we will add an attribute here, attr, and we need to add the style. Okay, now why I'm adding style, let's come back here, and you can see here we have width 0%. Okay, if we will write width 25% here, then what we will see, we will see a 25% progress bar. Okay, so we need to update the width. So for this we need to add an style attribute. Okay, so right now it is 0, and let's do it. So we will add the style attribute as width, and we will concatenate the percentage, and then we also need to concatenate the percentage sign. Okay, so this will display the progress. Now when the upload is complete, we will add the category in Firebase database as well. But first we need to get the URL of uploaded thumbnail. Okay, so for this we will create a variable here where thumbnail equals to, or thumbnail URL equals to upload task dot snapshot dot download URL. Okay, so by this we are getting the download URL of the image that we uploaded in Firebase storage. Okay, and we already have the cat name and category description. Now we only need to set, these values in Firebase database. Okay, we already have the database reference here. So we will set the values inside this database reference. Okay, so let's do it. So we will write, to add values in Firebase database, we can use set method, set function on a database reference. So we have database as the database reference, and we will call set. Now inside set, we can pass an object. So let's create the category object first. So we have where cat equals to, this is a JavaScript object. So what we have thumbnail and description only. So first we have thumbnail, and for thumbnail we have the thumbnail URL that we got here. Okay, then we have description, and for the description we have this DESC variable. Okay, So we will write it here, DESC. So we have the thumbnail URL and the description. Now we can simply pass this cat here on database.set. So the first parameter is the object that we want to save in the Firebase database. And here for the second parameter, we can pass a function that will handle the error, if any. Okay, so we can pass a function here with an error variable. Now, if there is any error, we can simply display the error message. If not, we can display the success message. Okay, so here we can simply do the same thing that we did here. So just copy this thing. For the error, we can display the error message, error.message. If everything is fine, we can display a success message. Okay, so paste it here. And this time we will define the class as alert-success. Okay, and we can simply display the message category added. Okay, or any message that you want to be displayed. Okay, now it should work. So let's test it. Let's try adding a new category. Okay, so let's add a category named nature, and we can write the description as beautiful natural images. Select the thumbnail. I have some thumbnails here. Okay, now let's click on the save button. You see, we got the message category added. Okay, now let's check the Firebase database. You see, the category is added. Now let's try adding the same category again. Okay, let's click here. You can see we get the message category already exists. Now if we will change the category to bird, category name bird, and we will try adding it again, then let's see what happens. The category is added and we have another category in our Firebase database, and also in our Firebase storage we have the thumbnails uploaded. Okay, let's check it here. You see, we have bird, we have nature, and inside the folders we have the files. Okay, so it is working fine. So that's it for this video, guys. We are very close in completing this admin area. I hope you found this helpful. If you are having any confusions or if you have any question, you can comment it below and I will try to help you. And if you found this video or this series helpful, please share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share it in your college groups. Okay, so thanks for watching, guys. I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.